ग्रीटिंग्स ऑफ द डे। आई गीता जैन, साइंस टीचर ऑफ क्लास 6, वेलकम यू ऑल। हियर आई एम विथ पार्ट 3 ऑफ चैप्टर 2, कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ फूड। वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड अबाउट एनर्जी गिविंग फूड्स एंड बॉडी बिल्डिंग फूड्स। नाउ इन टूडेज सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट विटामिन्स, मिनरल्स, रफेज एंड वाटर। Let's now talk about vitamins. Vitamin is very common word when it comes to healthy food and diet. Vitamin protect us against disease, so it keep us healthy. Overall, they try to keep eyes, bones, teeth and gums stronger. There are various types of vitamins. Vitamin A, Vitamin C, Vitamin D, Vitamin E and K. There is also a group of vitamins called Vitamin B complex. Instead of Vitamin B, why we are calling it as a Vitamin B complex? There are various types of Vitamin B. B1, B2, B3, B5, B6, B7, B9 and B12. So they all are clubbed together and called vitamin B complex. Vitamins are of two types, fat soluble and non-soluble. Vitamin A, D, E and K are fat soluble, while vitamin B and C are water soluble. Let's now talk about vitamin A. Vitamin A is very good for eyes, skin and hair. Vitamin A is necessary for good eyesight, healthy skin and hair. The various sources of vitamin A are the foods such as milk, butter, carrot, papaya, egg, etc. Vitamin B is essential for growth and proper functioning of the digestive system, heart, nerves and muscles. Vitamin B1 is present in good amount in milk, eggs, meat, whole grains, tomato, etc. Vitamin C is necessary for keeping gums and joints healthy. Vitamin C also increases the resistance of our body to infection and helps to fight disease. So, in this present scenario, to protect yourself, include more and more vitamin C in your diet. You get vitamin C when you include citrus fruits such as oranges, lime, lemon, amla, tomato, guava and green vegetables. Vitamin D is for the strength of teeth and bones. We get good amount of vitamin D from the sunlight. That's why those who have deficiency of vitamin D, they are always advised by their doctor to get exposed to the sunlight so that vitamin D can be produced in their body. We get vitamin D when we include egg, milk, cod liver oil, etc. Vitamin E. Vitamin BE is necessary to maintain a healthy reproductive system. We get vitamin E when we include vegetable oil, egg, liver, milk, palm oil, etc. Vitamin K. Vitamin K helps in blood to clot. That means it prevents excessive bleeding. However, any part of our body get cut, what happens? Blood starts coming out of that particular injured part. If bleeding continues, what happened? That person would die due to excessive loss of blood. Therefore, the presence of vitamin K helps the blood to cloth. We get vitamin K when we include sunflower seeds, maize, etc. Now, when we talk about vitamins, the next thing which comes in our mind are always minerals. Why minerals are important to us? They help to maintain bones, teeth, metabolic activities. What do you understand by the metabolic activities? That means the process which take place inside the cell, like respiration, circulation of blood. So all the process which are taking place inside the body and which are essential for survival of any living organisms are called metabolic process. Now some of the minerals which our body needs are iodine, phosphorus, iron, calcium, etc. Calcium is needed for making bones and teeth. Calcium also helps in the proper functioning of heart and other muscles, and as well as in the clotting of blood. Children need more calcium than adults in comparison to their body weight, because they grow fast and their bones and teeth are to be made largely from calcium salts. Some of the food items such as milk, cheese, eggs, green leafy vegetables and fish, if included in our diet, we get calcium. Phosphorus is needed for the formation of bones and teeth. Some of the sources of phosphorus are milk, pearl millet, that means bajra, banana, pulses, green leafy vegetables. Iodine. There is a thyroid gland situated in the neck of our body. It controls the growth of body. So this iodine is essential for the proper functioning of the thyroid gland, which controls the growth of the body. The various sources of iodine in our food are seafood, like prawns, crabs, yes, fruits, vegetables, iodized salt. These are the few sources. Iron. Iron is needed to make hemoglobin present in red blood cells, which carries oxygen from the lungs to the body parts. Thus, iron is an important constituent of hemoglobin in the blood. We get iron when we include spinach, green leafy vegetables, apples, eggs, liver, etc. in our diet. Dietary fibers and water. Dietary fibers are also known as roughage. Roughage is mainly provided by plant products in our foods. Roughage do not provide any nutrient to our body, but still we are considering as a main nutrient. Why? Because it helps us to get rid of undigested food from the body. We get roughage when we include whole grains, fresh fruits and vegetables, potatoes, etc. in our diet. Water. Water is essential for life, but it has no food value in our body. A person can live without food for several weeks, but would die in a few days without water. Water provides a liquid in which other substances can dissolve and move within the body, or helps to get rid from the unwanted sources. Water is needed by our body to transport digested food to the body cells, to transport chemicals such as hormones, get rid of waste, to control and regulate the body temperature. We get most of the water that our body needs by drinking water. Our body needs almost 2 to 3 liters of water every day. Besides drinking, we get water also when we drink milk, tea, coffee and juice. Many food materials themselves contain water. The fresh fruits and vegetables also provide us a lot of water. For example, tomatoes, melons, cabbage and lettuce. We also add water while cooking many food items. This water also goes into our body. Stay safe, stay home and keep learning.